In part 6 of my UI/UX design crash course series, we will cover visual style and trends. Visual style conveys a brand's character, which is crucial in making a digital product stand out and enhancing its usability and credibility. It's important to remember that in digital design, beauty isn't merely about aesthetics, but also about positively influencing a product's usability and user experience. We already touched some of the parts of good interface design in the previous videos, but in general it consists of visual hierarchy, composition, color, typography with readability, and visuals. Visual hierarchy refers to the presentation of graphic elements in a layout. The properties of this hierarchy include clarity, which is the effectiveness of the design in conveying the information, practicality, which is the way of how user learns what to do on a particular screen, and affordance. This implies that an element looks and behaves according to what it does, like a button that appears sticking out from the two-dimensional background and suggests that we can click it. Composition relates to the layout and proportions of elements in our interface design project. Under composition term, we can define its two primary elements. Consistency. It's crucial to maintain a uniform and predictable visual language for all graphic elements. If the interface incorporates icons, ensure they are consistently designed to symbolize specific functionalities. This guideline also extends to the interface's language. And alignment. Shifting elements from screen to screen without clear rationale can frustrate users. Strive to keep screen components stable when a user transitions between screens. Avoid arbitrary text alignment to the left, right, or center, as it can impair the comprehensibility and legibility of a digital product's design. Color instantly draws attention. It's among the initial elements detected in a design, alongside basic shapes and forms. While formulating an interface color palette, first eliminate anything that hinders text readability. I already published a great tutorial regarding colors in UI and UX design. You will find a link to it in the video description, and I strongly encourage you to watch it as well. But in short, tips presented there could be summarized as follows. Ensure dark colors are foregrounded against lighter ones and vice versa for optimal contrast. The readability can be assessed by utilization of tools like Web Aim. Should red and green be used to signify a crucial distinction? Strengthen the signal with varied shapes or text. If not, many color-blind individuals may miss the difference. Steer clear of specific color combinations, such as light blue text against a light red background, as there are complementary colors and thus straining to the eyes. Though black text on white background is typically more readable, the intensity of white backgrounds can cause eye fatigue. Therefore, if you are designing for tablet usage with considerable blank space around content or UI elements, consider a slightly darker background to lessen screen light intensity. Use color psychology and coral wheel to generate your palette, and then use 60-30-10 rule to apply them in your interfaces. Typography is a topic for which we could dedicate its separate course, but for our purposes, I will focus on three types that will be useful for you. We can distinguish three types of typefaces: serifs, sans-serifs, and decorative. For purposes of interface design, the most useful and widely adopted are sans-serif type fonts. And the reason for that is due to their simpler nature that scale down well, remaining readable even on small screens. Serifs and decorative fonts sometimes could be a good addition for elements like titles in dual typeface projects. But in general, I would avoid using them at the beginning. Apart from typefaces, I think it's worth mentioning concepts of leadings and trackings, which are distances between vertical baselines and individual letters. Too small or too big distances would contribute to difficulties in readability. So, while designing, you need to be cautious and make adjustments to text in your projects. Through visuals, we understand things like photos, icons, illustrations, and animations, which all provide an additional layer of expression and character to your designs. Photography can significantly contribute to the mood of a project and strongly express a brand character. Well-placed images can convey a story story efficiently and evoke emotional reactions. However, in most digital applications, content and usability are prioritized over style, so decorative images should be used minimally to avoid distractions. Icons are graphical depictions of concepts and functionality that replaces text. Icon creation, similar to typography, photography and illustration, is its own discipline, simplifying complex concepts for users. It's crucial to understand web UI and icon conventions to maintain user familiarity and reduce learning effort. Icons should have a consistent visual style, and remember not to rely solely on them. Use them judiciously and complement with text labels for user comprehension. Interface design trends change quite quickly. Most often, new releases of operating systems provoke changes in visual interface styles, which are introduced after their release. Tech giants like Apple, Microsoft, and Google set design trends for applications used on their platforms in this way. Skeuomorphism is a design approach which imitates real-world items. It was crucial in developing initial graphical user interfaces because people weren't familiar with many of the concepts. The arrival of personal computers and smartphones necessitated designs that would help newcomers swiftly comprehend digital navigation. Hence, skeuomorphic designs placed importance on mimicking real-world elements for user-friendliness, even at the expense of visual aesthetics. Skeuomorphism was extensively incorporated into early versions of Apple iOS across its entire user interface. Until the early 2010s, skeuomorphic design was prevalent, aiding a smooth transition to digital platforms. However, as digital literacy improved and people became more familiar with those concepts, the need for design elements to mirror their real-world counterparts diminished. Rooted in the minimalism art movement, the minimalist UI trend embodies the principle of less is more. This doesn't imply sparse or vague design, but rather emphasizes purposeful simplicity. This approach uses fewer elements to decrease clutter and amplify focus on the most important aspects. Minimalist interfaces streamline functionality and embrace negative space, bold colors, and distinctive fonts. If designed effectively, those interfaces are highly intuitive, devoid of unnecessary decorations, and guide users effortlessly through the design. Flat design is a UI aesthetic that focuses on simplicity, transitioning from realistic visuals to schematic elements simplifications. This design approach emerged with the launch of Windows 8, Apple's iOS 7, and Google's Material Design in 2012. It provided considerable technical benefits, particularly for mobile devices, by enhancing loading speeds. It adopts minimalism, so no shadows or ornamental elements, while utilizing vibrant colors and thoughtful typography. Despite its popularity, flat designs can pose challenges due to lack of visual cues, potentially causing confusion about interactive elements. Of course, there are many more trends like glass morphism, new morphism, or brutalism, but I think if you master those three at the beginning, you will be set. That's it in this part of the course. In the next one, we will cover lists.